Hi guys, I hope everyone is enjoying their day. At 10:44 p.m. local time, Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 3.8 earthquake near Talmadge, California. Actually pretty close to Ukiah. And that is in Northern California, near Clear Lake. It was a result of the Maacama Fault Zone. The Maacama Fault Zone is a right lateral moving fault zone. Here's the moment tensor ball. You can see the movement. Yeah, it moved slightly north. 244 people said they felt this earthquake. Just 3 days ago, there was a magnitude 3.4 near the same location, and there's the moment tensor ball. 121 people said they felt that earthquake. The 3.8 had an intensity level of 4, and it was reportedly felt all the way to the coast. Looks like Fort Bragg, all the way over there. Here on Google Earth, here's the location of the Maacama Fault Zone. Here's the location of both those earthquakes. And there's evidently a 25% chance of having a large earthquake along the fault zone in this location. It's capable of having a magnitude 6.5 or greater within the next 20 years. One of the more recent earthquakes that happened along this fault zone, they actually had cracking from an earthquake there at the Safeway parking lot in Willits. This fault zone also goes and extends up through Cobb Mountain, where they've been having a lot of earthquakes. Yeah, I mean, they happen daily there. If there was to be a large earthquake in this area, the city of Lakeport, Clear Lake, would probably have liquefaction along the shorelines. Some of the older buildings that are unreinforced masonry would probably collapse. I found a map that some of you might find interesting of the Maacama Fault Zone. Here we have Redwood Valley. We got Ukiah. I'll bring it down. There's Hopland. That's as far as it extended here. Let me bring it up. We got Potter Valley. And we'll come up a little bit more. Yeah, there's Willits. That's where that crack ended up in the Safeway parking lot from an earthquake. There's another paper. I'll give you a link to it. It talks about the Maacama Fault Zone and how it runs right through underneath the city of Ukiah. Based on their relative lengths, a magnitude 7.5 earthquake are possible on either the Maacama or the Bartlett Springs faults. He goes on to say that it is possible that an earthquake on the Rogers Creek fault could rupture into the Maacama fault or vice versa. This has a serious implications for the city of Santa Rosa, which suffered damage in the 1906 earthquake. In the last 30 days along this area, there's been 817 earthquakes that USGS does report. And of course, they don't report all of them, as you know. On the 26th, not far from Talmadge, again, there was a magnitude 2.4. 7 people reportedly felt that earthquake. And there's the moment tensor ball. In this location, they seem to be growing in size. And as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. These earthquakes were not far from Ukiah. And I've talked about Ukiah in the past. I've talked about the reservoir and the dam that it has over there, and the possibility of flooding if this dam ever broke. There we go. Yeah, we got Lake Mendocino. And yeah, you know, that is the largest man-made lake in California. My first home I ever bought was originally a garage that came from this area, that was moved when they built the lake, built the dam. Those that you follow me, you might remember that report that I did about the water and how this whole area would be inundated. Do you have an evacuation plan if there is a 7.5 or a 6.5 earthquake along this fault zone? And I've talked about how most earthquakes happen at night. Well, this one did too, didn't it? Have you discussed with your family what to do in a case of a large earthquake? And if this dam was to fail, where would you meet up? Where would you go? What direction would you evacuate? Besides the liquefaction that would happen along the shoreline of Clear Lake, you got the threat of the dam there in Ukiah. Are you prepared? Most people aren't. Something to think about. Please put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.